really super swell. Hello, my name is Drew Pickles and today I am going to talk about closing logos. Ones that are scary, and ones that are not. The logo I just showed you is not scary, but it is funny. The first logo I am going to show you is the BBC video intro from 1990. The logo itself isn't scary, but the music could send chills down anyone's spine. BBC. Broke my knee. Turtle bee. The music makes me think that someone died. This makes me think that the person who played that music was in denial, probably because of his wife leaving him for sleeping with over 15 other girls. Disgruntled musicians are a pain. The next logo is so scary that it made me run out of my house waving around a pooper scooper screaming ah. The evil glare of the totem pole bird can burn the eyes of anyone. The point that the creators were trying to get by was that totem poles are magic and can kill you, if you cut them down. Where, in this case, they talk creepy and say sneeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeee like Barney's gal sack. I like to scream, it's sexy and horror. That noise scared the ass out of me. Let's just get to the next logo. Sexy, it's cooler than Barney's anus. Look at Spider-Man, oh god, he's coming towards me. He's gonna rape me and he looks like he means business and the creepy music makes it worse. That was worse than the last logo. Let's look at one that people find scary, but I don't find scary. It's actually very pleasant and a nice gentleman tells you when your feature presentation begins.
Paramount is pleased to bring you our feature presentation.
My brother Stu is really afraid of this one, and I think he's a wuss.
Shut the hell up, Drew. It is super scary and you know that.
Oh, come on, Stu. I know you secretly want to have sex with the gentleman talking.
What the hell? Why would anyone do that? That man is creepier than Tommy Wiseau. And why do you look different each time you talk?
Don't worry about that. It's not important.
Tell me, goddammit.
It's confidential. I can't tell you. So how's your sex life?
That's not something I talk about.
Did you already make out with the man talking in the Paramount logo?
Well, excuse me, Drew, but I've got chronic diarrhea and if I don't get to the toilet we'll have a mess. It's chronic so I need to stay in the bathroom for the rest of my life.
I knew it. Yeah, you knew that. You can't cover up the truth. I know that you kissed that man in the lips. Well, he's gone, so let's check out another logo. That was interesting. If you didn't notice, on the bottom left corner of the screen, there is a spider walking around. Let's look at a few versions of this logo. That sound with the drum beat is scary, and the hammer goes so freaking close to the screen. That man's oily, greasy arm is so greasy that it looks like he dove into the Gulf of Mexico and got oil all over him. He's probably some big greasy metal worker with the name Jim or Bob. I ought to kick Tom Servo 3's ass for showing all of those. I'm glad he cut off the ending to some of them, but damn, those were scary. Tom Servo, if you're listening, I'm gonna throw a cow in your house like Thomas and Alfred would. Let's look at another logo which scares a lot of people. It only sends chills down my ass. No, I don't know why. Did you see that? It was Dick Entertainment. I don't care how it's pronounced, I call them Dick Entertainment. Here are two more versions which I find weird. I think they should just change their name to Penis Entertainment. I'd watch it a lot more if they did that. People call this the kid in bed. There is a kid in bed, and I'm betting that if he saw the word dick spelled out in the sky at night, he'd go running away screaming. Well, I don't have any more logos to show you. That was it. Until next time, I'm your gay old pal Drew Pickles, saying
bag,
that was swell. The abdomen, also known as the vagina. While most people find the combination of the V flying at them and the ominous music scary, I find it scary because of the V, meaning the vagina. If it was the P of Doom or the D of Doom, that would be super duper swell, and ironically, in those logos you would hear tag of Emma or swa. Anyway, hello, my name is Drew Pickles and I am the gayest man in the history of television, and speaking of television, I am here to do something I haven't done since late 2010. Talk about more closing logos. Why do people find them scary? Why do people shit their pants at the very sight of spools of film, Paramount logos, kids in bed, dogs, and other things? Nobody knows. Today I am here to go over some of these shit-inducing logos. This one is old but still brings doopsicles to underpants everywhere, the Screen Gems S from Hell. I have to admit that I used to find this one scary, because I thought it was too warm slowly reaching to grasp around a woman's nipple, but nowadays I don't see anything scary about it. If you ask me, it should be called Screen Tits, because that's what it looks like they are grabbing here. This next logo is the definition of gay rapist. The screen fades into an old man staring creepily at you taking a toy rainbow out of a box. It zooms in on his rapist stare and the words, "A rainbow release," are spelt in an arc across the screen. A hurrah bag, that was actually somewhat swell. Fun fact, the man in this logo is none other than Orson Welles, the director who did Citizen Kane. You might know him better from this.
Green penis.
Despite the creepy factor of this logo, it is still pretty cool, and the gay rainbow would be a great dildo. Tag on to talk about overdramatic. And no, I don't mean the hammy music playing while the Paramount logo is being zoomed in on. I mean the people that complain about how fucking scary this logo is. What is it with people finding not scary Paramount logos scary? Remember I went over the video presentation logo back in 2010, and my brothers too had a shit fit.
Shut your pie hole, you shit-faced dick-eating sperm slip ass. That logo is scary as hell, and so is the Closet Killer logo you just showed.
Closet Killer, really? You weirdos even have a scary name for this logo. I can't believe it, that's insanely stupid.
Would you stop being an asshole? This logo is one of the scariest I've come across in my years of being alive.
Shut the hell up, Grandma Llama. Enough of this chicken shit bullshit, let's go to the next logo. That one made my 300-mile-long pee-pee penis hide inside my butthole, which actually feels good. Hold in, I'll be right back. People have told me to go fuck myself, but this is ridiculous. Using my 300-mile-long cock and 500-ton balls, and dildos pound my rump. Now time to go hard like a retard. Meg, that lost well.
You might have been aroused, but I saw your reaction. You were scared like I was. You get scared of logos too.
No shit, Stu. Everybody saw how scared I was of some of the logos I reviewed 4 years ago. You're just being a dumbass. Listen, since you won't get out of my goddamned hair, why don't we watch a closing logo that we both get spine and anal tingling chills from?
Spine? Anus? Oh god, I know which one you're going to put up.
Yeah, that's right, that one. Here it is.
Sit, Ubu, sit. Good dog.
I don't know why that one scares me, but it does.
It's just mad creepy. The deadpan voice, the still image of a frozen dog, and the silence. Want me to make it creepier? I will read about the dog in a creepy voice.
Please don't do that, you soup drinking cheese puff.
Ubu's master is Goldberg's dog Ubu Watt, a black Labrador retriever which he had in college and subsequently traveled the world with Point the Closing Tag. For Ubu Productions is a photograph of Ubu Watt with a flying disc in his mouth, taken in the Tuileries garden close to the Louvre Museum in Paris. Along with the picture is Goldberg's voice saying sit, Ubu, sit, good dog, followed by the sound of a bark. The dog was named after Ubu Watt, an 1896 play by Alfred Jerry that is considered a precursor to the theater of the absurd. Ubu the dog died in 1984, but this logo was still used after he died. It is a ghost dog. A ghostly, no-faced dog, haunting you forever.
Let's just get on to the next logo.
It's a really freaky logo.
This logo helped me learn how to pronounce plastic supo. I used to say plastic supo.
Yeah, I had always thought it was pronounced ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba. This was from our own show, so we had to see this logo a lot, especially the older version. To me it looks like a dyslexic baby made it, and the music was a cat walking on a keyboard synthesizer. Fun fact, this music is on a 10-minute loop in my rare 1998 porno, Pickle Me Timbers, where I play a gay pirate who fucks all the other pirates on ship. I did you all a favor there and showed you a nice, calm logo with kick-ass music. You'll need to be relaxed, because we have the granddaddy of scary logos coming right at you next. So fucking scary that it makes you take a huge explosive wet dump on Barney the dinosaur and scream, as you force him to smell the poop, while saying I cannot smell my poop you dino bit cheese I cannot, while grabbing your crotch like Michael Jackson screaming out he just beat it off, while Barney gets so excited from the poop experience that he turns into Barney the poop colored shitosaur and says and starts to wag his dino bit back and forth, while doing the Macarena, shooting grenades out of his butt and into a butt-smelling elephant head who just took a good 7 years to escape the underworld of elephants but now is blown back into obscurity forever.
You all know it. You all fear it.
What can you say about this logo that hasn't been said? The audience is now deaf. It's one of the scariest sounds ever, one of the most well-known pieces of computer-generated music in existence, or my personal favorite commonly said phrase about it, it sounds like Chewbacca getting his Wookiee ass violated by eight TIE fighters. The sound, known as the deep note, is used in a 2001 porno I did called Deep Throat, where I get surgery or make my throat 300 miles deep so it matches the size of my peepee penis. I bet you thought I was gonna say I sucked cock in it, right? Well, you're wrong. THX is so big and powerful like my cock, and like my cock, it does end at some point. You can't get much bigger than THX, so this is where I will end my review. Until next time, I'm your gay old pal Drew Pickles saying brunnies are the creepiest fuckers in the planet.
Oh my god, oh my god, oh my god, look at the gay colors, am I the representing the gay poopy faggots, am I the sweet mother of Barney, look at all the hot, sexy, sweaty men in the screen, am I nice hot woman better smack the screen, with my cock smack, am I god, all the rainbows are so swell, it's driving me bonkers, this might be the sexiest opening logo ever, am I the cum times,
swass,
that la swell. Well, as you might have guessed, I'm back again to talk about closing and opening logos. I've also decided to include some swell bunkers as well. Many of these logos would make great dildos. One that would make a particularly swell dildo is the Program Exchange logo, shown here in its 1987 incarnation. As you can see, it is a double-sided dildo, to for the price of one. The music is slightly eerie, which is why I play it when I'm about to rape a man in a dark alley at night. It makes him too scared to move, leaving his asshole vulnerable. Tom Servo 3 remembers seeing this logo around age 4, but Tom Servo 3 saw the later version of the logo, which came about in 1993. This is quite a nostalgia trip. All this fourth wall breaking has made me horny, so my Ronald McGoddamn Dildus Donald, better known as Penis Clowny, and I will use the Program Exchange logo as Dildus.
Hello, my name is Ronald Donald, better known as Penis Clown, and I'm here for the Dildo Exchange.
Tom Servo 3 is a graphic designer and enjoys old logos. Looks plus they remind him of when he was little. I'd use the fourth wall pieces as Dildus, but I'm already using this swell logo as a dial now. Look at the arrow going into the penis clown's bum bum. It's so hot. Tom Servo 3 remembers seeing this logo at the end of Dennis the Menace way back when. Dennis the Menace. More like Tamest the Messes. Egg, that last swell. Hey, penis clown, remember the time homosexual Simpson asked those police officers if he could use their donuts as cock rings and they got offended and told him it was racist?
I sure do, Drew. Then we all died and you said you should have been brought the meat.
Well, this next logo here consists of not one, but two cock rings. Here we have the Cineplex Odeon logo from 1993.
Ooh, I'd love to shove my 6 mile long salty french fry in that.
Well, what are you waiting for? Get to it, penis clown.
This was a good idea. This feels so swell. Oh my god, it reminds me of when Penis Fred clamps my cock between his world famous loaf of penis bread. That was swell.
Here's a suspenseful logo that's sure to make your pubes stand in attention. From 2002, it's the Surround Sound Company logo. How much more basic of a company name can you have than Surround Sound? Unless the company invented Surround Sound, then they have no right to use that name.
Well, actually, true. The company's name is based off of the two creators, Donald Surround and Bernie Sound.
You made that up, penis clown.
You got me.
That wasn't even funny.
Drew. I have a logo for you.
Arnie, this isn't your video. Get the fuck out.
But Drew, it's the scariest logo in existence.
Arnie, only I pick the logos.
Drew, trust me, you will shit your pants in fear.
Well, I could go for some poopy, so play the clip.
What the fuck, Arnie? That logo wasn't scary, it was fucking retarded. Fuck you, you are grounded. No more using Arthur Reed's penis as a special until Justin Bieber's balls drop.
No.
Personally, I'd love to see those letters star in their own gay porno. Imagine the peak penis possibilities.
For any pedophiles watching, here is a logo for you. The Fox Kids logo. Or, as I like to call it, the Fox Kids logo.
Fox Kids. Fox Kids. Fox Kids. Fox Kids. Fox Kids.
Did you hear that? It sounded like it said Fox Kids.
Let's hear that again.
Fox Kids.
Now let's hear it again.
Fox Kids.
Now in slow motion.
That's enough, penis clown. I know it gives you a boner, but we're already 4.5 minutes in and need to get to more logos. Here's a couple of logos that scared the shit out of Tom Servo 3 around age 5. Tom Servo 3 remembers seeing them in the beginning of some VHS tapes he owned, possibly his Yellow Submarine VHS, which I hear is quite the collectible now.
That fanfare is what plays during my Ronald McDonald, better known as Penis Clown Productions logo. Just take a listen. This has been a Ronald McDonald, better known as Penis Clown Productions.
Ronald, you just added that music to advertise your company to our swell viewers.
Well, now it's the music for my logo.
Here's the other one, from the 90s. This one really scared him. It's the silence combined with the moving colored lines and the frozen line illustration. It still creeps him out for some odd reason. Personally, I want the line to be my blowjob slave.
Hey Drew, since it is a requirement for me to appear once in these logo videos, I brought you a logo, and it's really fucking scary.
Mercy, that was scary but sexy at the same time. Am I a butt sexy? Get it? As in butt sex. Here's a really really happy and gay logo. The Sunbow Productions logo from 1984. I bet the Cube Muppet would love to shove that sun up his ass so it could burn his bum bum, but no satisfaction for him.
Now we'll look at a couple bumpers from the now shitty Nicktoons network. In 2003 to 2005 it showed amazing old Nick cartoons and had fucking weird bumpers. This one in particular gives Drew a massive boner.
Oh my god, I know which one is coming and not coming.
I love you.
I love you too, you sexy piggy stud swah 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 bag. I came in my pants. Now here's one that is infamous for being scary, from the 1990s. For some reason it's called Pinch Face. Well, I see a face, but there's no actual head so there's nothing to pinch. The only thing for me to pinch is my ballsack, while I bang my head hoping this bumper will end.
I once saw this used as a sign, off for Nick at night, and afterwards there was a test pattern. Imagine seeing this late at night and then just a long beep and test pattern. Freaky!
Fun fact, the voice of Pinch Face is none other than Tom Kenny, who does the voice of that yellow dildo known and loved as SpongeBob SquarePants, who we know has the gayest nose in the world. And now a cameo from Barry the Motherfucking Giraffe.
Hey, I'm Barry. Barry the Motherfucking Giraffe, here to show you logos from the streets. This one is a fucking classic.
Sucks was recorded in front of a live audience at Nickelodeon Studios in Orlando at Universal Studios, Florida.
That's what it is. Now here's a theater policy ad from Lowe's, bitch.
Lowe's Theaters welcomes you.
Welcome to the hood.
World of the movies.
Wait, I can't smoke cigs? Fuck who the year. I'm out of this, bitch. You know what it is, that's what it is, bitch.
Thank you, Barry. For our last logo of the day, we show you a logo from a porno company with a cheesy name, Videorama. I bet they made some great gay pornos.
Drew, I have some bad news. Videorama was a straight and lesbian porn company.
What? Oh my god, I showed a straight porno logo. Oh my god, I showed a straight porno logo. Oh my god, I showed a straight porno logo. Oh my god, I showed a straight porno logo. Oh my god, I showed a straight porno logo. Oh my god, I showed a straight porno logo. Oh my god, I showed a straight porno logo. Oh my god, I showed a straight porno logo. I'm so pissed that I won't even have a final speech. Bye bye.
My bag so yummy and so gummy. This is a gay porn logo. My bag. I can't wait to watch some gay porn. My bag. You know you're gay when you even jack off to a porn logo. I'm gonna jack off so hard to this gay porn. My bag.
Using my remote controller as a dial. Sometimes that was swell. I guess it's time to watch the porno.
What? What the fucking fuck?
It's censored. Oh, right, this is YouTube, and they don't want porn on YouTube. Well, might as well make the best of it. Hello, my name is Drew Pickles, and since I'm not able to watch hot, sexy, sweaty gay porno, let's talk about logos. That logo right there was a logo from Fox Studios, which was a gay porn company in the early 80s that used music by gay disco legend Patrick Cowley. The colors make me super duper horny. Gay colors, you know. Hemata. Well, let's get into this autistic gayness, because many people who talk about logos have autism. Keeping on the subject of hot, naked, sweaty men, here's a logo from the Japanese company Caution Video.
talk about intense grunty orgasm. That man is pretty hot, and there's another variation.
Ow!
This one is howling, and the reason he is howling is because he got kicked in the gal sack. Are you ready for more gay logos? Well, too bad, faggot. I'm showing them anyway. This one depicts a green boner glowing. It might look like a tree, but it's really a boner. The Arab Films logo from the early 80s. This logo is from Spain, and unfortunately I did not see it when I was a fledgling young porn star. Just my fucking luck. I have to admit that I was reluctant to show the Japanese Kitty Films logo from the 1980s, as Kitty could be another word for pussy, as in that yucky funky thing women have beneath their pants, but decided to put it in, because Tom Servo 3 likes the music. There is another variant of this logo that some dumb faggots may find unsettling. What do you think, fuck nut? See for yourself. This music is played in a loop in a 1991 porno I made called Movie Theater Semen Shootout, based on a shooting that happened in a movie theater in Tom Servo 3's town in Christmas 1990, except instead of people dying, I just turned them all gay by shooting them with my semen without their permission to do so. Pretty hot, isn't it? This very rare logo has been talked about by Scoot69 in one of his logo videos, but it's just so creepy and interesting that I showed it. It is in the beginning of the Tales of the Quad-Dead Zone VHS tape, and as far as I know this is the only movie to have it. It sounds very similar to part of the music in a Mort Garson song from the album Black Massachusetts. Despite the creepy factor, I would totally shove my pee-pee penis into the hole that the logo forms and fuck it really 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 hard and destroy its anus. The only reason I want to show you this next logo is because the name is so fucking funny. Packin', as in fudge packin'. This is yet another Japanese logo for a video game and publishing company. It makes me want to do some serious fudge packing. Great, now I got a boner.
Hey Drew Pickles, as you know I'm always supposed to make a cameo in these dumb fucking logo videos, and oh ho ho ho, do I have a good one.
Oh joy, it's my foot-loving brother Stu Pickles. What have you got for us today?
If you're in the mood for sexy BDSM, it will make you really fucking horny. That was the High Tops video logo from the 80s. Tom Servo 3 saw it at the end of her Charlie Brown and Snoopy Show VHS tapes.
Looks like it could make for some sexy BDSM equipment.
Oh yes, Drew, I'd love to have a man with smelly feet wear the high tops and tie his laces around my cock and jack off my lacy cock. Oh 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 oh, yummy yummy sexual gayness.
Why does everything you talk about have to be related to feet? Cut that shit out.
Feet are my life, Drew. Let me talk about it to make myself horny, you faggot.
Fine, whatever. Go smell Donald Trump's or in Jack's whole feet and fuck off. Your cameo is done.
Oh 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 oh, Donald Trump is sexy. I am going to go do that now. Oh yes, oh yes.
Here's a somewhat scary logo from the Philippines. Reuploaded Films, 1988. Oh my god, we are flying up the screen. I wish I could let it fly into my anus and it could be a sexy slingshot logo. It's a very sexy looking R and I would let him be my sex slave any day. Speaking of which, here's another Reuploaded Films logo from the 1970s, featuring a sexy furry faggot. Glurg, sorry, I just couldn't help it. Glurg. How can you not fuck the king of the jungle when he's such a fucking stud? Glurg, suck my gargantuan dick, you lion boy. Glurg. It may not look mastodonic, but we had to use special effects so you could see all my dick. It's really 300 miles. Glurg. Also, Chris Chan's penis is bent. Glurg. Now, wow, he bit my cock, which has sharp loony teeth. Wow, glurg. Oh, Conicum, for the king likes swa. That was swell. Now I'd like to present a new segment I'd like to call Autism Corner. I am going to show you a logo, and then I'm going to show you a remake some autistic logo fetishist did in Yalub. This is the Sony Wonder logo that Tom Servo 3 saw in many Christmas special VHS tapes. Now here's the autistic remake. Pretty fucking shitty cringe, isn't it? I never understood why logo fetishists exist, or why they are all autistic boys, but they give these shitty logo videos views, so they are okay in my book. But I'd rather say, okay, in my anus nook, as in autism cocks in my ass fa-fa.
Oh.
The O Entertainment logo came to being in 1998 and it is sexy for numerous reasons. 1, it's a tight hole that I can fuck with my 300 mile long cock. 2, there's a sexy man mommy and I bet he also has a big cock by the sound of his voice. And 3, this logo is seen in the O Entertainment fun movies, and those are sexual and swell. The next logo has pedophile written all over it. Fun fact, the original master tape to this logo smells like little girl feet, because Dan Schneider is a fucking fat pervert and demanded that it smell like his favorite aphrodisiac. And if you thought this shitty and funny video was done, oh no my good man, I've got more logos coming at you like a triggered femi-Nazi who sees a man breathing. Here's a logo you may recognize from the DVD show Eddie, which was about sexy fuckable boys who lived in a world with no adults. Oops, that wasn't the right copy. I sort of shoved a glass bottle in my ass and it broke, causing anal blood to squirt all over the logo. Oh well, a logo covered in anal blood is pretty sexy bullshit. Anyway, now it's time to show you a logo from 99.
Hello, my name is Ronald McDonald, better known as Penis Clown, and I'm a gay faggot clown boy who works at McDonald's and likes to fuck children and use them as dildos. One time, I was watching TV at a children's library and I put in a VHS tape and this logo featuring an underage letter came on and it made me really horny, and this is what the logo looks like. Yes, the logo I'm waiting right now, which is from 2000 or so, it's for Golden Books, better known as Golden Showers, and it makes me hornier than horny. I have fucked that little letter G so many fucking times that you could not believe, and each time it makes me super duper horny. And now before I go, I must show you a logo with an egg that would be great to shove inside your ass. Enjoy it. Bye-bye, my good men.
Well, that happened. I don't know what to say, but Ronald McDonald, better known as Penis Clown, does shit like that sometimes. I am very confused, and confusion makes me horny, so here's a logo with a face that I want to make a cum shit all over from 1986. He is so fucking hot I can't stand it. Well, why not cool down with another logo? Here's one that's guaranteed to chill you out. And by chill you out, I meant fucking confuse you. This is the Mordock Productions logo from Cambodia. A pretty good one, if you ask me. Oh, what's that you say? It's only okay. No faggot, this is okay. Okay Productions, that is, from India dating to 1993. And here's another Indian logo, this time with a sexy man speaking in his native tongue, called Man Boob Productions.
Muddai laakh bura chahe to kya hota hai, wahi hota hai jo manzoor khuda hota hai.
I don't care what it really says. It's Man Boob Productions to me and will always be Man Boob Productions. The translation of what he says is, as follows, the plaintiff might wish you a million ills, but what of it? That alone happens that God allows what ills? Obviously sexually transmitted diseases, such as AIDS, gonorrhea, herpes, scabies, genital warts, chlamydia, syphilis, typhoid fever, Fiji flu, and diabetes. The music in the next logo is what some of you millennial faggots might call Lador Secrets. It's the Bryanston Pictures logo from 1974. I often wonder who does the music for these logos, and if they ever released albums. If any of them did, they would be a cult classic among electronic music fans and autistic logo fuckers alike. Well, it's about time to wrap things up. I'm tired, and so is my penis, and me, and my penis, need to take a nap. So I am going to bend the rules for our final clip of the night, though that annoying kid moaned, as Mark NES Star Fox got mad when Tom Servo 3 first did this. I am going to show you a relaxing bumper from Nickelodeon, shown in the late 80s and early 90s. I hope you faggots enjoy that bumper, and that you all got a laugh at this terrible, shitty, boring and funny video. Keep in mind that Tom Servo 3 is not an autistic logo fetishist, so, if you send her tons of logos to talk about, she probably won't do it. Until then, I'm your gay old pal Drew Pickles, saying fursuits are fucking retarded.
Head off on E.